Two arrests were made related to larceny and credit card fraud in Brattleboro, and police say they are not done. They say more arrests are coming. News Channel 5's Jackie Bender is live in our Upper Valley Newsroom tonight with more on this story. Hi, Jackie.
Hi, Gabby. Police arrested 36-year-old Sylvester Little of Brooklyn, New York, for allegedly lying about his identity, and 46-year-old Pamela Johnson of Brattleboro on charges of fraudulent use of a credit card, among others. Local business owners are being extra vigilant in the midst of the holiday shopping season.
Well, the person came in the store, someone I'd never seen before, and he was interested in looking at pieces that we know are highly suspect when people ask for them.
Caitlin Wilkinson says she's trained her staff at Renaissance Fine Jewelry to be on the lookout for credit card theft and stolen goods that would be brought into the store by customers. So when a man came in a few weeks ago to look at gold chains, she knew something wasn't right.
None of them were heavy enough, which is kind of a cue for us to consider. And then he wanted to look at diamonds, which we did very carefully, and at that point he decided to buy one without any extra information.
Police say larceny and credit card theft have been a problem in Brattleboro. They've made two arrests and are expecting more. Wilkinson said she was able to identify this case of credit card fraud before she made the sale.
When he pulled out a credit card that wasn't his, we knew that it was most likely stolen. So at that point we told him we could not accept it. We wrote down the name of the credit card and the information. He left the store. We called the police.
Store owners around Brattleboro say they're working together to educate each other about the problem.
I just think that when the community works together and we alert each other and tell each other, which we do, and we have been doing in downtown Brattleboro, it really prevents a lot of theft.
Police say that there have been several cases not only of fraudulent credit cards, but also fraudulent checks and larcenies. Gabby.
So, Jackie, did store owners give you any tips for other business owners about what to look out for?
They did. They said to always check the credit card information against the person's license and ask questions about their birthday, etc., and always have lots of staff around who will be on the lookout for suspicious behavior. Live in the Upper Valley Newsroom, I'm Jackie Bender, News Channel 5.